もう大丈夫。
はい。
Hello everyone, this is presentation of Group D. This group is formed by five members, which are Tomoko Taka, Yoshiaki Konishi, Hiroya Kobayashi, Tomoe Doi, Emi Nakai. The title of our project is The Alternative Pudding. My name is Tomoko Taka. I'm in charge of introduction. According to a 27th survey conducted by the Committee for Research on Allergic Disease, 329,423 students out of 12,773,554 students attending public elementary, junior high, and secondary school throughout Japan have food allergies. It is about 2.6%. According to the Ministry of Health, Labour and Welfare, eggs are the most common allergies causing serious immediate allergy reactions, followed by milk and the same of the two rate exceeds 50%. In addition, by age group, eggs and milk account for 62% of food allergy in 3-year-olds. Therefore, if children can make their favorite pudding without using eggs or milk, it can reduce the risk of life of children with allergies and the stress of their parents. Also, by comparing the nutrition of substitute foods with the nutrition of egg and milk, we thought that it could be recommended for people with certain disease due to uneven nutrition or restricted intake. An example of a disease that develops due to the imbalance of nutrition is hypercalcemia caused by an excess of vitamin D, and an example of a disease that has a restricted intake is restricted intake of potassium and phosphonium due to renal failure. I made this project because it can be useful for people suffering from allergy and certain disease and for those who are play group of those diseases. This time, we decided to definition of pudding. It is whether the shape remains when spooned with a spoon, scooped with a spoon. Next presenter is Yoshiaki Konishi, please.
Okay, I'm Yoshiaki Konishi. I'll talk about allergies and pudding without milk.
Allergies mean that the immune function overreacts to an allergen and contained in a certain substance, causing various symptoms in the body. Next, I'll talk about pudding without milk. I'd like to introduce a pudding that uses a different one instead of milk. We made two kinds of puddings without milk. They are almond milk pudding and soy milk pudding. The ingredients for two almond milk puddings are 200 ml almond milk, 4 gram powdered gelatin, 1 egg, and 15 gram caster sugar. Next, I will explain how to make it. First, put almond milk in a bowl and heat at 500 watts for 1 minute 40 seconds. Second, add powdered gelatin to it and mix well. Third, add egg and mix. Last, add caster sugar and cool for 2.5 hours. When I added 2 gram powdered gelatin, it didn't harden, so please add 4 gram powdered gelatin. Figure 1 shows the almond milk pudding. When I scooped it with a spoon, the shape remained properly. And it tastes almost the same as standard pudding, but has a slight almond taste. It is also recommended for those who want a slightly different pudding than usual. Next is soy milk pudding. The ingredients and method are almost the same, except that the 200 ml of the almond milk pudding is changed to 200 ml soy milk. And figure 2 shows soy milk pudding. When I scooped it with a spoon, the shape remained firmly. And the color is slightly different from almond milk pudding. I felt that it was the same taste as the standard pudding. Please go on to the next section.
I compared the nutrients. 200 ml of milk and each substitute almond milk. The items are energy, calcium, potassium, phosphorus, protein, lipid, cholesterol, carbohydrates, and vitamin E. And the results are shown in the graph 3 and 4. Replacing milk with almond milk can reduce phosphorus intake to about 1/7. In addition, since almond milk does not contain cholesterol, it is effective not only for allergies, but also for prevention of metabolic syndrome. Next speaker is Tomoe.
Thank you. I made pudding without using eggs. I will show you how to make it. This is the material for 6 puddings. Assuming 60 grams for 1 egg, I calculated 118 grams for 3 eggs. I replaced this 118 gram egg with tofu. I made 6 puddings because I thought that if the only ingredients were tofu, the color would be so far from the original pudding. So I use 4 kinds of vegetables. Look at this figure 5. From left to right. Number one, tofu only. Number 2, tofu and carrot. Number 3, tofu and carrot and avocado. Number 4, tofu and pumpkin. Number 5, tofu and pumpkin and avocado. Number 6, tofu and yam. Next, I will show you 3 points of reflection. First, I thought that I added yam would make it even smoother. For this reason, I added yam to number six, but when the yam added, they did not sit and were unable to maintain their shape. Therefore, number six made with yam cannot eat as pudding. Other vegetables could keep their shape. Also, number six was so not delicious when I tried it. So you shouldn't use yam when making pudding. Second, although they are not in the pictures, adding only avocado doesn't taste good and it doesn't look delicious because it was green. If you want to add the avocado, you should be added with other vegetables. Third, the main point to make delicious pudding is to put all the vegetables in a mixer. If you put the vegetables in without mixing, the pudding is not be smooth. And I think that the sweetness of carrots and pumpkin made the pudding delicious. Look at this figure six. I found that the pudding looks more delicious when it is colored by vegetables. Next presenter is Emi Nakai. She will talk about nutrient comparison, please.
I compared about 60 grams of egg and its substitute tofu. And the results are shown in the graph 7 and 8. This egg also has a lot of phosphorus. The intake can be reduced by substituting tofu. Since tofu contains less sodium and potassium than eggs, it is useful for preventing health problems other than allergies, especially for preventing high blood pressure and lifestyle-related disease and for dieting. Next, last speaker is Hiroya.
In this section, I will talk about discussion and conclusion. In order to compare the color with general pudding, we conducted a questionnaire to investigate which one are similar to pudding. Look at this figure 9 and 10. This figure shows the result of a survey of how similar pudding made with almond milk and soy milk look. Many responded that they dipped pudding in both almond milk and soy milk. Almond milk and soy milk had almost the same color as milk, so they didn't affect the color of pudding. As mentioned above, almond milk is low in cholesterol and rich in vitamin E, which is a very healthy and effective substitute. As we mentioned earlier, many replied that tofu and pumpkin and tofu, pumpkin and avocado are similar to pudding. It was found that tofu alone doesn't look like a pudding as a substitute for egg, and it doesn't look like a general pudding unless other coloring materials are used. Tofu and pumpkin are healthier than egg and similar in color to pudding, making them effective substitute. However, in this survey, it was not possible to take a questionnaire by tasting and comparing the taste with general pudding. Vegetable may affect the taste and may affect the survey result. Pudding is a form that cannot be eaten by people with milk or eggs allergies. Milk replaces almond milk and soy milk, and eggs replace tofu. Almond milk and soy milk have pudding-like color. However, tofu does not have the color of pudding, and it is necessary to add a new ingredient to tofu. The study found the almond milk was an effective alternative to milk, and tofu and pumpkin are effective alternative to egg. Thank you for listening.